Welcome, day 370, Megan Songbringer, and today I'm fixing some bugs, because last night I posted an update to Steam, and man, I'm really excited about it. There's so many new items, and the weapons in the game now are so versatile. It's really cool. Hey, what's up, Teak? Welcome, man. How was your weekend? So right now I'm working on this one little bug fix where if you're playing the game like in Italian or some other language, and it doesn't have a string for, like, for example, there's one string that hasn't been translated into Italian, then it's going to use the English as a backup. What's up, Rocket Bunny? You had a birthday? Or a birthday party to go to? If it was your birthday, then happy birthday, man. Yo, Scottish pizza! What's up, Scottish Pizza? Come on. You're 24? Whoa, cool. So I'm going to take a look at what's, I got some code written here, which will, it should back up any strings that it doesn't find. Like, it's going to loop over strings, which is all the Italian strings, and strings N, which is the English strings, and just match them up. So if there's anything missing, it copies it over. It looks like it read all the 385 different strings so far into the English and the Italian. Let's see how many got loaded for Italian. Hey, what's up, Zilton? You gonna name a bug Gerald? All right, dude. This bug is named Gerald. Yeah. Gerald the bug. He's more of just an unfinished feature at this point. You know, loading the English strings instead of whatever language you're in. If it's missing, where the hell is this? There it is, strings. So it loaded 311 Italian strings. You finally got study leave. Woo! Nice. How long? You started learning arrays in C++? Cool, man. Right on. You're on to the next step. Rocket Bunny is learning C and C++. He's only 13 years old. And, proud of you, Rocket Bunny. That's cool, man. You got over art block? Good, man. Sweet. So this one is three. Okay. Let's see if it gets to there. Right. So if the regular strings do not have the given key, hey, what's up, Arcane? Cool, you made your map saving format better. Sweet. Yay, does it look better, the 720p? Constant capacity, arrays! Nice, I like how you got the triple platform in there. Yeah, Rocket Bunny. Hey, what's up, Salad Dongs? Avast! Yes, Zilton. Nice, Zilton. Good, I'm so glad the text is crisp and the video is better. Through a lot of crazy magic, if anybody is watching these streams and you want to do streams as well or whatever, I found some settings that work really well for X264 where I can get a lot of quality video out of very little bitrate. So my width height here is 720. This is just the ratio that matches my display for the height of 720p. The encoder is X264. Frames per second, just set at 15. Average bitrate, this was important, putting that around 1250. The quality level being 3 really also made a huge difference in it not doing these weird glitches. And then setting these max rates and buff sizes a little bit more acceptable than the average bit rate. And then also making sure it's keyframed aligned. But I think this applies to a lot of different X264 encoders. So just so you know, maybe that helps somebody somewhere sometime. Okay, so if we have this string, what is this string? Get key. Get child K version. Do we have the string version? It's looking for that. Let's see what it passes back. Yeah, it has that string. Okay, so great. That part's working. I'm gonna run to this point now. Right on. I'm glad the stream quality's better. Oh yeah, they're mockumentary. Look who's back, huh? That's crazy. Have you seen what was it? It's called. Kung Fury almost has the same plot. Hitler is actually alive in the future. No, whoops. Kung Fury. This is a rad movie. It's only half an hour long, but it's awesome. If anybody also wants to watch a thing about Hitler getting his ass kicked, that's a great, funny movie. Yeah, Kung Fury. It's probably would inspire some people out there, I'm sure. It's great. Great film. So here's the key, right? Strings, current size. We're trying to insert a string here. This is the current size is 311. We want to insert i.getKey, i.getStir. Which becomes beta, version, blah, blah, blah. All right, so yeah, it's... So the Italian strings are missing this string right here. He's kind of the good guy. Whoa. So it just goes ahead and sets this key and value. Oh, that's going to ruin all the strings. Wait a minute. This val tree... Ah, yeah, no, this is totally wrong. All right, we need to look up the key or insert the key. How does the hell does that work? Set string setting, set setting, sibling. Oh, saves.getChild, settings key.getChild key. If sib is null. Oh, it's add child. That's right. Dot add child. Okay. So this needs to be strings dot add child. Oh, and this was, I think this has made more sense using the val tree version of it. So we create a val tree. Oh no, we already got one. This is a val tree. Bam. Okay, let's watch that. When does this game enter the gamma stage? The gamma stage. I wish I had an exact date on when it enters the gamma stage, but I don't have any exact dates. I could tell you at the earliest the gamma stage could be like end of summer or early August, early autumn. On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is Xcode? I give it an 8. It's definitely my favorite IDE, but there's still some things about it that just are really kind of annoying because it's just like, if they had just done a few more things better, it could be like way better, especially with its... It's autocomplete and it's quick open and it's tabbing. Oh my god, its tabbing is kind of annoying. They use a totally different tab system than any other software. They make every tab its own like little workspace universe here, which is way different than the way other editors work, where when you open a new tab, it just allows you to view that file. Whenever you switch to a certain file again like that, it opens that tab again. Dedicated tabs for per file versus this system where each tab has a workspace. I don't particularly like this workspace layout, but it's kind of one of the minor points. It's a minor gripe. Did that get off? All right, so what do we got? This vowel tree, we're looking. Oh yeah, same thing. Beta. It's trying to insert the beta string. Great. Let's see if it was. So just be children, not push back V. This should work. We get out of here, and now the strings has 312. Bam! I think that worked. Okay, so now if I run the game and I'm playing in Italian and I'm gonna go walk over some grass and pick up my first diamond, and it will do the "Ooh, I found a diamond" text. And even though that's not written yet in Italian, it will still show the English text. Come on, find a diamond. There's gotta be a diamond around here. No diamonds, shut down. Come on. Dude, usually you find a diamond like right away. Dude, this sucks. Didn't find a whole diamond the whole time. Spawn a diamond with god powers. I wish. I have not written any kind of spawn a diamond code. Yes! All right, cool. And there he's playing the English text. Awesome. Great, cool. And it still says Coraggio down there. And Mappa Equipaggiamento. Army plus abilità. And then, okay, yeah, once again, we don't have the diamonds text yet in Italian, but at least it has English. Great. This bug is now fixed. I'm gonna go check this in. Get status. All it does is just load any backup English strings that it's gonna need. Really simple. Oh, this is noteworthy though. Put this in the change log. Everything noteworthy goes in the change log. Nice habit to be in. Keeping your change log up to date. Fix. If a language string is not found, the English string is used. Yeah. Gerald's dead. Gerald lives on in other translations. That's the whole point, though, is that he doesn't live on anymore. He does not live on no matter what translation you use. All right, so, next bug on the list. This is a really weird one. Last night when I did my playthrough, I didn't have an elevator going into level one. It was weird. Game idea, you play as a bug. Yes. You have to avoid being detected by playtesters. There's a game already like that? So let me give the player the sword. And the top. No, we won't give the player the top hat. Yeah, because I need to test that. So this ought to be enough. Want to just run to level one and see if. See if it bugs out on me. It does that weirdness where it. Wow, Spaventos Amico! Che adora Billy Brami! I don't even know what lines they're saying. Okay, we'll get the top hat. That top hat. Johnny Cilindro! Where is level 1? There's level 2. But I swear, I went into level 1. And it had. Whoa. I'm in God mode, and so it started this dialogue in the middle of, whenever we forget something, that's him. Where is level one? Scene I'm playing today is called Zelda. This is the last night's scene. I was like, I'm finally doing the scene Zelda. Can I start the second adventure? Here we go. Okay, so let me save here. What? Crash on exit? This happens every once in a while. I don't know why sometimes, but it's only in debug mode. I think. I hope. Alright, so I want to see that level. Wait. It didn't save level 1. Oh, is this level 3? This might be level 3. It's level 3. So weird. Okay, anyways, that's level 3, damn it. Okay, where's level 1? Yeah, look at this. There's no freaking elevator in level 1, and I'm so confused. Why? How? Oh, I realize what's going on. Oh, we put some gate tiles right here. In invincible mode, invincibility was on. Put some gate tiles right here, and I can't. That's why I can't. Oh, I get it. I get it now. Can you guys hear the game's audio? Can. Okay, so I put a gate tile there. Or did it? All right, so there's a function called add gates. This name is Gate Consumer of Lifts. It totally did. It's a perfect name, Zilton. Man, you're spot on today. Okay, so if this just, let's just say if it has Flag's entrance. I just want to see really quick if that's what's causing this bug. Gate consumer of lifts. Oh man, if this is what it is, then it's kind of a relief. Oh, this is such a relief. Wow, such a relief. The elevator's back. No, but it's really a relief to me because I thought that the whole game was broken on level one. I was like, oh, the game broke. I broke the game. But it's not. It's fine. It's just that it placed this gate up there. And why does the gate? It's really weird that the gate would like override Flags or something. Or set the exit number. Baal, eater of worlds. All right, what if it wasn't the grow back tiles? I'm trying to understand this bug because I don't want this bug to happen again. So let me make sure I do this the right way. The gate, let's force this gate number to be gate number two and see if gate number two also breaks it. Because I would prefer to be able to have these gates on the entrance there as long as their flags aren't stepping over each other. They shouldn't be stepping over each other, the flags. Maybe it's not the flags. Maybe it's something else. Key here is understanding it. It's not changing the gate type. It's so weird. Oh, I think it might be overriding. Oh, this totally makes sense. I think I get it. There's like a gate tile, or there's a entrance tile. What kind of tile is that? Consonants. Okay, tile. Entrance? Oh yeah, it's K-tile entrance. Should never ever override K-tile entrance. If this is tile, let's get some constant vector tile type. Don't overwrite. Don't ever overwrite these tiles. K-tile entrance. That's one of them you should never ever overwrite. No, you're not trying too hard for comedy, man. There is no such thing. There's never ever such a thing as trying too hard for comedy. Don't overwrite. I could make this more elegant by making these all a short function, but I don't know. It's kind of ugly seeing all this like that. Oh, whoops. You know what? This is wrong. I do need to make this a short function. Auto set tile. No, this is, I've already got a function named called set tile. Right tile. To int x, int y. And capturing don't overwrite by reference. Okay, if it's not the override tile, then set it to ktile none. Oh, gotta capture this. Capturing, bam! Captured. All right, so now we got a write tile function, and we can go like this. Bam! Write tile. This makes the code cleaner, but also it just makes it better because the X and the Y for both of those checks need to be the same. I didn't want to write all this twice. It's called code cohesion, kids. Gotta keep yourself in the ken. In the know. Tefen! What's up, Tefen? You finally made one of these streams. Oh, it has been a while, man. How have you been? How's everything going? What you been doing? Blam, it works. We have the, oh, nice. We have the entrance tile here. And we have the thicket tile still here on the, whoops. Thicket tile still up here. And we have a flexible algorithm, so this time we can, if we need to add things to here, we can add things to the don't overwrite tiles, and then it won't overwrite when it's adding these gates. All right, that's another bug off the list. Ball eater of world, what is it called? Oh, wait, now we got to take off this forcing N, which I don't know why that didn't work. Oh, because it clamps it to the max. Oh, duh. The maximum for this gate type, or the maximum gate type in Dungeon 1 is already that gate. That's why it didn't ever, that N didn't work. Yes, Zilton, show it if you can. Can you actually show it? Oh, you can. What does this do, man? This is so cool. I'm so glad you're doing this. This makes me happy. No, we've always talked about this language on this stream. Nobody's ever written any code in it, though. You're the first person to even attempt writing code in BrainFuck, and that's you, my friend, are a pioneer. It says hello world. All right, man. Did you really write it, though? If it's hello world, I want to see something else. How about you? You give us, dude. You got to give us a name, right? Give us a brain fuck application that says one of your names, and but it's a start. It is a start, man. It is a start. All right, so this elevator work, I'm sure this elevator works now. This is awesome. Okay, that's a great bug fix. Let's check this one in and make note of it. This is a noteworthy change log. Fixed some dungeon entrance elevators. Which dungeon entrance elevators sometimes being Completely missing. It's a really good bug fix. If I could create a programming language, I would recreate Ath from Homestuck. Is it cool? What is Ath? Hold on, let me check out Ath here in a second after I check this in. Right. Okay, this is right tile, right tile, which just says if this is not one of the override tiles, then right tile. Great. Blah blah blam! Two bugs already fixed in today's stream. That's amazing. Level one does have an elevator. It was just hidden because of some crazy code. Oh, till death. Oh. What? I can't find any resources on this programming language. Oh, yeah, wait, oh, here it is. Is it called AF? No, this is a... Oh, is this it? Aw. Hey, it exists in both Earth and Alternia. Its logic is composed of nothing but infinite loops. This program loops forever and does nothing. Any code deviating from this pattern will not compile? Oh, you mean this is the pattern? All right. Ath this. This dot die. Wow, this is really morbid, huh? Whoa, you can embed images? Wow. I know, right? Most programming does basically consist of infinite loops that break eventually. Get out of the loop. Bifurcate this, import universe. This seems like your kind of language, Zoltan. All right, here's the next bug. Droth mini boss appeared right after the flux slide. Going for the third bug today so far. So I need to get rid of the top hat. I need to get rid of a lot of my positions. Let's get down to maybe like that. And starting at the beginning and diamond one, entrance dark, fine level zero. Let's take away that. Refill, we saw zero. No, let's not see zero. Yeah, okay, this can work. And let's take off some time. We got 13 diamonds, the sword. Okay, ready to do this. I need to encounter the mini boss. And I think what needs to happen is I need to trigger some dialogue right before I go and trigger the mini boss. And that will cause him to do this weird glitch where he appears. Oh, see, there he is. Okay, I needed to go up to... Alright, let's... I think that's exactly the same area I encountered him in last time, too. We need color-sensitive code. It's a... Oh, he's right here this time. That's great. Okay, I didn't know he could be used right there. Now, if I get this dialogue off, I can trigger that pretty easily. running the dialogue right now. Still got dialogue. There's a delay happening. Bam! See? This guy appears out of thin air because the dialogue just finished and it was blocking him from appearing. And I'm pretty sure that this is all fixable with one line of data. I don't even have to change any code on this one. So in the story text, whenever I spawn an enemy, I need to do a different kind of, where's Brutus? Brutus. Oh, this is spawn any Brutus. Spawn any. But anyways, it needs to be this, is flux slide. Sword boss, mini boss zero here. Spawn, but make sure this is flux slide. Okay, let's do that again. That C++ variant is real, Temple OS, yeah. Nice. A slightly less than sane man who believes that random number generators are means by which to communicate with God. Wow. Wow, that's cool. Just eccentric crazy. Yeah, yeah. How does one go about making a programming language? The first thing you do, Zilton, is design it however the hell you want. The second thing you do is make a compiler. Bam, there you go. Two things, you got your own programming language. You can make your own right now. You wrote an esoteric language? Crazy! That's awesome, Teak! Using pixels. So, okay, let's run this test again. I'm going to make sure that this is fixed. Drop mini bosses doesn't randomly appear if you're already playing some dialogue. Actually, I think I can stand right here. He'll do that dialogue and I can walk straight to the right. Yeah, okay, here's the dialogue. Alright, good. I walked onto the next screen and there should have been the dropped mini boss right there. But since it blocked it, it's not gonna just go randomly appear in the middle of the screen somewhere else. So we're almost done with this dialogue now. Still running the dialogue timer, I believe. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 1,000, 5,000. It's definitely already done with that delay. So if I go to the next area, since I'm not running any dialogue. Oh, no, there's a story element there. Okay, hold on. Alright, dialogue everywhere. Gotta wait for all the dialogue to go away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, yeah, that time it worked. I think the last time it didn't work because it ran that zero story up. Oh, I'm stuck behind here. I wasn't stuck. Oh, cool. Hey, wait, does this guy, can I get him trapped behind here? Oh, I'm so hoping I can get him trapped up there. I'm almost dead. I think he's making him go away. He's trapped. I got you trapped. You're so trapped. His hornerang doesn't hurt the growback, so. I want his shit to hit that. But that's another bug fix. Done. Boom. Another one off the list. That's three bugs fixed already in today's stream. It's amazing. Change log. Gotta mention this. Fixed. First mini boss sometimes appearing out of thin air. Right, Alexa. Hey, space my name. What's up, man? Welcome to the stream. Okay, so blam, that's another bug fixed. Down to 50 cards on my now list. Yeah, I want the elevator walk to stop the story. What was I just thinking though? There's something else. Some little. Oh, fighting this guy. I want the grow back. I want the guy to be able to. The horn rang. Attack category shot foe. So I want the grow back tile to be able to be hurt by shot foe. Okay, so this time he should be able to hurt these. That'd be cool. He's not here. Did I already get the top? No. What? Oh, here he is. Okay, he appeared at that time. Oh, because it's Flux Slide. That works. That totally works. Then you can't, like, you can never, Yes! His order rank did it! Yeah! Get in here, buddy! Get in! Let's have a party inside here. Oh man, he didn't get stuck in there that time. But anyways, that's working pretty well. Blam! Joni Cilindro, Conquesti Gio Cattiloni, Puyo Lanchiari, Il Capello a Cilindro come un boomerang. USA or Equipagiamento? Alright, good. Another bug fix. Another one crossed off the list. Let's get on to the next bug on the list, which is what? Not exactly sure. I want to make sure that when I spawned him right there, it doesn't save Brutus. Okay, cool. Did not save Brutus. Good. Good, good. Okay, so the next thing I wanted to be, when you walk on the elevator, it stops any kind of story zoom that was already going on. Little touch. Okay, so I want to be at level one, and I'm going to go up the elevator. And it runs this little zoom in right here. Okay, so let me save it. And take off the little zoom it just did. So now I want to trigger its zoom and then walk straight onto the elevator, and it will kind of look weird. There'll be a visual glitch as the Z goes brrr. The camera Z. See that? Weird, weird, weirdness. Okay, so I need to cancel any running lens zoom. Hmm. Oh, there's already a function in lens. I think it's, oh man, it's gonna be clear all like, there's a clear effect here. Clear forever effects, clear all. Man, even now I need maybe an clear not forever effects. Yeah, I guess we basically need a function called clear temporary effects. All right, so the temporary effects clearing is like this one, but a little, whoops. I got a better idea. I'm gonna make this one private method. Clear effects bool forever. Okay, so I'm gonna call this clear effects. Wait. Bool forever. Clear forever effects. This clear effects. True. And then clear temporary. Clear effects false. And so this one is forever. Or this one, iteration is greater than or equal to zero. If not forever. Oh my God, I just saw a way to make this way simpler. Oh my God, oh my God. Color code. What? Why is this not a member function? Oh, are these statics? Static, static, static. Lens. Gosh, so this logic seems pretty obvious to me now, but this is just the same thing as this whole complexness right here is the same thing as saying forever equals iteration is less than zero. Haha, I love it when code falls away. Okay, now I just need to make sure this works. So I'm gonna set a breakpoint here and there. People make computers from billiard balls, really? Kovarni Pidor, what's up, man? Can you imagine how to combine cooking knowledge and programming. Ooh. Good question, Kovar. Maybe you could program something. Okay, I got something for you. You program something that makes up its own recipes. So it's a procedural recipe generator, and it has to create good, its goal is to create good tasting things. So you need to somehow input it, create like a neural network or something like that, that like you input all the things that you think are good flavors of flavor combinations, and then it figures out how to get all the right flavor combinations, and it creates you a recipe. And it has to understand how food is cooked and everything. Only a cooking genius and a programming genius could make something like this. Were you listening? Yes, smoke a doobie soup. Maybe. I don't know. Right, so I want to do that and that. And right before it runs the lens, I think it's lens zoom to, it's in flux. We're talking about elevator down to go into the elevator, also elevator up. Both these are walk to, and walk to also has a zoom to. No, wait, no, that's not right. Oh, yeah, it is. Okay. Oops. Oops. Phase walk to. Phase walk to. Phase walk to. Nice. Right on, man. Thank you. Phase walk two, it's gonna do something where it runs a lens. Here's where it moves next to stairs, move next to the elevator. And where does it sit to zoom? Zoom, zoom, zoom. Is it at the end? Oh, here it is. If do zoom. Nice. All right. So we've got if do zoom. It does the zoom thing. And we want to go lens. Clear temporary effects. All right, it's zooming. I'm running up here. Great, it's calling clear temporary effects. Let's make sure this works. It's gonna loop over all our effects. We have two of them running right now. These should be lens, yeah, lens wander and lens follow. Both of these should be negative duration or whatever. Lens effect, duration zero, duration zero. Ooh, this is wrong. This needs to be less than or equal to zero. Because this is going to go forever equals false. And also, the duration is not less than zero. So it's going to go ahead and delete that. So that's wrong. So this needs to either be less than or equal to zero. Yeah, I think that's. Yeah, duration zero? Of course. That should be less. That should be forever. Okay. I think this code should work. I'm gonna disable both these breakpoints. Right? It is, that does sound kind of fun. Explicitly thinking about the amount of memory a certain string should be allowed to take. I think that's pretty cool that you're doing that because also what that's going to allow you to do is to not have to compile string every single time you compile any freaking file because of the way the whole STL is templated. You know, It costs a lot of compiler time to compile C++ programs. So if you write your own string class and it's nice and simple, it's not too complicated, it should be a lot faster to compile. Thank you, Kovar. I know, right? Templates are. And they're not exactly, I mean, I get their utility. I understand templates, and why would you want to use them and stuff like that, of course. Damn it, that didn't work. But like, it's just the way they're implemented. It's like obfuscating your own code. And still some people not playing or watching Overwatch. What's up, Chocolate Beer? It's been a while since I've seen you on here. I hope you've been good, man. Easier than Python. Why didn't this work? It was supposed to clear the temper. All right, I guess we do need to see the breakpoints. Turn on the breakpoint. Import soul. Yeah, and it makes it so difficult to follow the call stack. Right, yes. I forgot all about debugging, but yes, hell yes, it's so hard to follow. You never want to step into one of those methods too. You're like, oh my God, no, step out, step out. Don't step in even further, because all it's going to do is go down and down and down the rabbit hole of templates. Template function calls, template functions I can't even read. Okay, this time, let's see this. Let's see what happens this time, huh? Lens wander, lens follow. We should not be deleting either of these. Both of these have a duration of 0. So, if forever false equals it duration is less than la la true, it shouldn't delete. Just go on. Allow this to make. Yes, very good. We still have both of these function, these intact. Oh, but it's still zoomed in. The camera is still zoomed in from its other zoom. Okay, so that worked, but I just still need to make it so like unzooms the camera. I know, I only wanted to know what this code's doing. There is a function in here somewhere where you can set the cameras. Oh. It's in, let's see how the lens. Think it's lens zoom. Let me check it. The story system is what is the one moving doing the zoom. Lens, yeah, it is lens zoom. Psychedelic shake, lens zoom. Push effect, lens zoom, duration from to lens ease cause. I think from should be the unit vector to reset it. And this does base.outside. And clear camera base. Okay, that's gonna be jerky and abrupt, but oh, wait a minute. What if I just It looks like it did correct the outside camera, and then yeah, okay. But yeah, both outside and inside start with unit Z's. So if I, whenever it clears all the effects, it's going to clear both these and set them both back to unit Z. Hopefully that is what was needed. Oh no. Oh, I know what's going on. It's running the end of the lens zoom. In the story system, it delays and then it does. This could all be a lot clearer if I just turn on the story system verbosity. Show me what it's thinking and doing. So there, it's running its zoom in. There's one action left, timer, delay, blah blah. Okay, I got a way better idea than trying to fix this anymore. This is just getting to be a nightmare to try and fix. So instead of. Instead of this, I'm gonna go. Whoops. If do zoom and the lenses get camera pause equals the unit Z. So there. Now we'll only do this if it doesn't already have some other kind of. That's not right. It's not quite right. All right, I think I need to add another method to try. think I need this static method. Static bool is camera zoomed. That's all I want to know. Is the camera zoomed at all? Has anything done a zoom besides a permanent zoom? So if do zoom and not lens is camera zoomed. Okay, let's hope this works. Is that all I'm gonna do? Just hope it works? I'll set a breakpoint so I can see if it works. Ugh. It's a busy ass weekend this weekend getting this last beta update out. Okay, camera zooms. I walk on here. It should be like, oh, the camera's already zoomed, man. Cams base dot outside. Cams final. Right. Oh, nice. So the camera Z is 909, which is a little zoomed in. And the inside is still 001. But the outside, see, if I had tried to compare this to the final outside, it would have definitely been something weird because this thing is all adjusted because of its camera follow, camera, the other camera effects. So I think this is right. All right, so let me stop this and then I'll do this again. And this time I'm going to let the zoom finish. So it zooms in, zooms out. Okay, now if I walk on here, this time it should be cams base dot outside is back to one. Bam, it is. So that is gonna be return true and all that. So let's disable this breakpoint. And now let's try it all out. It's zoomed in. I get on here. It just stays zoomed in. And it zoomed out too. That was pretty cool. That worked. Perfectly. All right, cool. Now taking off that story element. Let's see it again. So this time, I'm gonna let it zoom in, zoom back out. So it's now changed the camera. It's done some things. And this time, when I walk onto the platform, it should zoom in. It didn't. What? Does it ever? Oh, it doesn't ever. What the hell? Oh, you know what was happening? It was pushing on a null effect. And that was what was causing the freaking camera to flicker. The cam desk was already unit. But regardless, I've developed some good little methods that I can use in the future in this system. So this time, level one is already been done, which means I'm gonna run it again, and it still shouldn't zoom in. Great. This time I'm going to take the camera back out for two reasons it won't be zoomed in. Or it won't zoom in again. Right, cool. And I'm noting this in the change log. Fixed visual camera zoom glitch when using elevators. So the real key here is that first of all, it's checking the cam desk to make sure it's not the exact same thing as the source. And then secondly, it's also making sure the camera is not zoomed already. So if the camera's already running some kind of effect. And also the clear effects function is nicer now. It's probably good for something. Good, let's commit all that. Yet another bug solved on today's stream. This is the most bugs I think I've ever fixed in one stream. It's amazing. Four. Oh my God, I can't believe I fixed four bugs today. What? And I'm sub 450 cards now. 49 cards left. I'll probably get to only 10 or so more of these today. A lot of these are pretty easy up here. So, anyways, I'm working on some bug fixes. Save the bugs. Bug murdering streak. Do I have enough time to do one more bug? Whoa, no way. There's potentially 45 minutes left. I don't think I can do all 45 minutes left in today's stream, but I'll do at least one more. This is really important. Acid pillars. Acid doesn't kill the right pillars. They have feelings. Bugs are made for squashing. It sounds almost like the boots are made for walking song. These bugs are made for squashing. But that's totally wrong. That's the opposite of the meaning of that song, right? Okay, anyways, let's go to the acid pillars. I think I first encountered these in Dungeon 4. Let's go to Dungeon 4. Was it Dungeon 3? No, it's Dungeon 4. Let's find those acid pillars. Whoa! Totally mess up the camera. These sands are made for debugging. Oh, and that's what I'll do. Like, it does make sense. Oh, damn it. I messed up the. Oh! Oh, you know what? I guess what's really wrong here is the clear forever effects. I think this is somehow getting called, and it doesn't need to be. I think it's calling being. It's always been wrong. It was always clearing the not forever effects before. Right, so that's called from phase slide end. Yeah, this is wrong. It shouldn't be calling that. At the end of a flux slide, take that out. That's some ancient code. Now that this is fixed, just revealed that. These hands are made for debugging, I'll tell you that. But I prefer creating. I like being creative. Maybe that's why I like video games so much and making them. Okay, walking through the door, walking through the door. No whammies. All right, we got no whammies on the freaking killing the camera effects. All right, now I need to find the acid pillar. What was this poof? What poof? What should be poof? Oh, it was one of the Mac system sounds? Oh. I wonder what my Mac was trying to tell me. Where is the acid pillar? I'm almost dead. Oh, secret wall right there. This guy. There it is. Okay. Okay, so last night I crafted the poison sword. Man, I gotta optimize my game. There's some serious craziness going on there. Totally just got my fan going, and hopefully that doesn't mess with game show. Anyways. So we need the ghost sword, the poison sword, have you guys seen the new blinks? The blinks are freaking awesome now. Let's make R my blink. Check this out. Top hat's pretty cool now too. It falls off it's dis as a with distance, so it gets louder when it comes gets near you. What's super cool about the blink having this AoE effect like this, when you land, you hurt enemies, you hurt like pillars and stuff. Cool about it is that once you craft the blink with like some fire or some ice or something, it just gets really awesome. Let me show you. Actually, this is such a rad item. Let's turn it, let's do ice. Ice blink. Yeah. These are sweet, right? Check this out. Ice freezes enemies. Fire burns enemies. Fire is really cool too. Fire's kind of tricky though, because you gotta like it burns things, but you can also be burnt by fire. So it's you gotta be careful with the fire, and you have to kind of keep running with it too. It helps if you. Lightning's pretty awesome too. Boogie! What's up, Boogie? Isn't it a bit OP? Trust me, Teak, it is not going to be OP. Because once you actually get that far in the game, that you will need those kind of items to be able to start hurting enemies. Eventually, the enemies are going to double in their hit points, double in their damage, and all that kind of stuff. So it's going to get the game's going to get a lot harder, and you're going to need the items. Trust me. The first few levels are easy as hell. They're that way because you can't have super hard levels at first, or else you piss everybody off. Check out the lightning bleak. This one's pretty cool too. You got back from vacation? Sweet, man. Where'd you go? What'd you do? So lightning's awesome too. Lightning's great because it always hits enemies. That's pretty neat. Randomly does one lightning bolt hits the enemy that you just hit, and then one lightning bolt also randomly hits somewhere else on the screen. So sometimes you can get lucky and hit like two enemies with the one lightning bolt. Or one lightning land or whatever. From Cali, sweet. Right on, get some of the sunshine over here, huh? There's the poison blink too. Let's see that one. And there's also fear blink. They all have different AoE effects. Poison's great because it does damage over time. So all these guys that just got hit with that one blink are getting hurt. Rad weapon now, and it's really useful to get into and out of things. Here's something cool, you can actually blink through. Oh, if this wasn't a double row of pillars, you can actually blink through pillars. Bafu was there. Bafu had blackout sunglasses on, and he was sipping a Corona with a nice lime in the top. The fear blink is cool too. Fear causes panic. So enemies start running around in circles and stuff. Panicked out. You're all panicked. You don't know what's going on, do you? You're panicked. And it does damage once the panic wears off. So it's kind of a cool. It's a really cool element, fear. Okay, enough showing off those. All right, so now I would need to fix this bug here with the poison sword. For some reason, it's not killing these acid pillars. So momentarily, I'm gonna get rid of all the enemies on the screen and just focus on the acid pillar gate thingy. Hey! Well, that's supposed to be no foes, not only foes. It was pretty cool, huh? Yeah, we had a really cold weekend here in California. Okay, so that poison should have hurt these. It's not. What if I had the poison? Let's do the poison blink. And the poison top hat. Just give me all the poison. What else were we missing? There's another poison you can get. Oh, look. Yeah, the poison AoE works. Okay. No sword doesn't. What about the top hat? Oh yeah, top hat works fine. So it's just something's wrong with the ghost sword. It's not doing its elements. So we'll go to use ghost sword. No, it's launch ghost sword. Launch ghost. Why don't you have poison? Ooh. Oh, it's collision categories. Ow. I broke this last night when I was fixing something else. Okay, so these all need to be shot. Got attack. Got category. Another easy bug fix. Right on. A lot of these have been easy today. I love easy bugs. Okay, so yeah, top hat still works. Oh, nice. Now, one thing though, I know the sound effects are really weak. I really messed up those sound effects. I'm gonna go take a little quick look at the sound effects for the acid pillar because they need to be better. First sound effect is when it dies. That's just a horrible noise. You have to give a lecture? Cool, Rocket Bunny. You're gonna be like Rami, yeah, man. Oh, that wasn't that bad. Yeah, that actually wasn't too bad. Maybe I was just thinking something else. Said, don't have the poison sword. How do you even make games in 1D? That's right, that's crazy. I bet you could, though. I bet you could. There's gotta be a way. Little sound, but I'm not gonna worry about it right now. It's okay. Okay, but let's just check this bug in for another fix. He can go all the way to 5 bugs in one stream. All these are just changed to shot, not attack. Dot category. That also means, let me do one cursory check here to just say that if I had something like the fire sword and some enemies on the screen, the fire sword would work. Yeah, cool, we got fire. With the blink just being so awesome now, I want to use it all the time. Okay. It's always a good sign when you end up playing your game more than you intended. It's always a good sign. Alright, so all this is just fixing collision categories. So, well, this is totally noteworthy. This fixes every single ghost sword elemental. Fixed elemental crafted ghost swords to properly carry their particular element. Another one bites the dust. Yeah! I think that's all the important bugs I had planned for today, too. The rest of these are more cosmetic and stuff. But this one's not. Actually, Jib getting stuck behind the growbacks. This one should be higher priority. Hyperdimensional games. Hey, is a Tex Adventure 1D? Or is that 0D? The first person to make a 4D game, I'll pay 150 euros. Rocket Bunny, I already know there are games already in 4D. There's a guy I met recently who made a four-dimensional chess. So the way his four-dimensional chess works is that it's just like three-dimensional chess, except that instead of just having one three-dimensional cube, he had like 64 different three-dimensional cubes. So whenever you moved from one, you could move from one cube to another cube with one of your dimensions. So you've got X, Y, Z, and W. W just moves you to a different cube or whatever. So there already are 4D games. I'm not sure, the graphics aren't exactly 4D, but it is a four-dimensional game. The math works out. What's his name? I will pay him. I forgot his name, man. He's just this guy I met at GDC this year. Oh. I don't remember his name. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guy. I don't... If you're out there, guy, and you're watching this right now, please remind me. Get in touch with me. And you're going to win 150 euros, man. So there's your incentive. Arguably, a text adventure is 3D, since they usually involve moving around in 3D space. Uh-huh. But you do cardinal direction. That's right, Saladong. Saladong doesn't point here. Hey, Steve Trabby. What's up, Steve Trabby? Megacure, Hide and Reveal. Is this also 4D? A true 4D puzzle platforming game. Whoa. So this is, there you go. 4D. Megacure. You're gonna break it! Wow, this looks really good. So, but how is it 4D? Okay, so are you going from different one of these cubes to different same kind of concept? Whoa, what is that? What's that? Whoa! Oh, I get it. We're folding, we're seeing everything in three dimensions, but we're folding into a different fourth dimension or whatever. Crazy. This is cool. Wow. I'm impressed. Oh, that's so cool. The art for this is amazing. Yeah, movement along a fourth dimension. Yeah. I know, Rocket Buddy. It's okay. It's okay. I'm joking. If anybody ever comes and demands 150 euros, I'll pay it, man. It's all right. You don't have to worry about it. I was the one that just purported that. That's really interesting. This looks like a very well done game. Is this on Steam? Where's the Steam link? Oh, PlayStation, Linux, Microsoft, Windows? Why would they not be on Steam? Oh, it's coming to Steam. It's coming to Steam! Why aren't you on Steam now? Cool. I demand 150 euros. Everybody demands 150 euros right now. Oh, it's not even out yet? Oh, okay. I think I can get one more bug fix today. Jib getting stuck behind the grow back tiles, which he totally does. He always did it in a Verloc room. So if I go to dungeon one, has a hyper volume of 500,000 meters cubed. Whoa. Hey, Blood! What's up, Blood? How you been, dude? How was your flight back? Y'all good? I got the Hey Guys for you, man. I got it. We're all good. We got the Hey Guys done. I think it's right here. Somebody, yeah. So I'm set the save here. Yeah, meters hypercubed. It was very long, but you made it. All right, you're back. Oh, what? So if I go through these pillars, these grow back tiles here, oh, I need a key. Give me a key. Look at this. We haven't had a BC Warrior train in a minute. That's great. Oh, it puts me right onto these. Oh. Okay, so that's what happened. Jib gets stuck behind these growback tiles right here, because now he totally pathfinds now. If you guys haven't seen, oh, check this out. Jib pathfinds. If you didn't know, he can get around anything. Oh, whoops, I set my time there. He's like, oh, I got a path to that. I got a path to anything, because I'm Jib. What? Did he use my key up? What the hell? Oh, I just haven't got this puzzle solved yet. Yeah. They were getting claustrophobic because they were locked in. So do you see that? The player walked, just barely walked like a pixel too far onto the top of these growback tiles, and so I can walk over these growback tiles. I can walk on anything, actually. It's a total bug, and Jib is completely stuck behind there. So all I gotta do is make it so it doesn't walk as far. That's in phase walk to, no, phase slide. There's a little bit where it walks extra. Where's the walk extra part? Now here it is. If doors are locked. So east west, I did a whole 10 pixels. Let's do a little less. Let's do 8 pixels. I don't want to walk too far. It's a feature, ship it. No, I'm actually really excited. I was watching a lot of playthroughs of Zelda, old Zelda, and Zelda 3, and I'm so excited by all the glitches people find in video games. I really can't wait until people have found all the glitches in Songbringer, you know, and they're exploiting them for speed runs. Because that's completely out of my control as a programmer. You know, I can fix a lot of bugs, right? But no matter how many bugs I do get fixed, there will still be some in there. There will still be something, some kind of bug. It gets stuck in the game. It gets left in there somehow. Even if I fix it on Steam. And I will probably keep some of those glitches in there. If it's a really cool glitch, I'll be like, keep it. That is awesome. Okay, that was good. It walked me an extra pixel there, but I think it only needs six actually to put the player like right in the middle. I can't get used to my time, but I need to wake up in 4 hours. Oh no. You're just powering through it now? Yeah, you definitely have to keep them in the code, right? If it's a sweet And good. So it put me just 2 pixels shy of the growback tile there. I'm clearly between the door and the growback tile. All these spiders with only the blink. Yeah, got you. Combat a lot more interesting having several kinds of totally different weapons like this. Like the blink is such a rad weapon. This guy has a lot of hit points, so that's why it's pretty hard to kill him with just this blink and some poison. On, go down, man. Oh, not again. This is not working out. Yeah, I'll give one more try though. I'm just proud of myself that I can blink all these spiders to death. I feel like I'm a really accomplished player right now. Probably that's just a feature, man, so everybody can feel like they're accomplished players. And he's poisoned. Whoa. Maybe he can't be hurt by the actual blink and he's only getting hit with the poison. That might be what's going on. This is like really not fair. Actually, maybe it is fair. Maybe this is exactly how this Verloc guy needs to be. He shouldn't be able to beat every enemy with every weapon. Let's see. The Verloc. Its hit mask is shot friend shot, blah 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 blah. Oh, it does get a hit by the blink. It's just the blink's not very powerful. Okay, so I must have been really close to beating that guy. What do we got? So there, you can't walk onto the screen. Let me just check that that works in reverse as well. And also north south. We're just Jib go? Jib, where'd you go? There he is. He was stuck behind there. Okay, I'm walking west, and this time, good. Okay, so I'm right in the middle of the tiles. We're all good. And then let me check dungeon 4 going north. Yeah, Boogie, it does have that. The enemies do show their health above their heads, but they sometimes get blocked by their AI they're currently running, so it's not always there. I think that was dungeon 3. Oh, what the hell? Oh, it's dungeon 1. Okay, cool. Yeah, here's the dungeon 1. Let's make sure this can work too. Good. Okay, so it walked me a little bit extra, but... Oh no, it didn't walk me extra because this is not a locked room. Okay, I'm gonna hack the game really quick. Foes. Corridor. Set flags locked. I think that'll add the lock flag. Stellaris, huh? I think I've heard of Stellaris. Which one is that again? Okay, good. It did lock the door that time. And it did walk me onto these tiles. That's a bug. Alright, it's a good thing I checked this. Phase, what phase is this? Phase slide. So we were walking north and we walked a few pixels too many. I'm guessing maybe only 2 pixels less. A mini golf themed Doom map? Is it the new Doom? Oh, it's the old Doom. Nice. Bob's mini golf. I still want to make your Valtry live debuggable. Oh, cool, man. Yeah, it's called Valtry. It's on GitHub. Good. Okay, we're a pixel shy of that. So this time, once again, we did not get blocked by those. Okay, next up, I want to go the reverse direction. He's using your name, Helen One? That's great. That's a great name. This is 3, 2, 1. We want to be at 3-1. And locking. We need to lock. Oh, wait a minute. I could, instead of doing this, I could just do the flag entrance here. To tell your world, didn't you just use a whole bunch of textured quads? No, I did not use textured quads. Unless you're talking about the 2D, the way that my 2D, the 2D engine works, Cocos 2DX. I think you're talking about the procedural generation of the game, though, Songbringer, and it's not, it does not use textured quads. So now I want to check that walking southwards also does not clip into the grow back tiles. So this bug is solved once and for all. I'm going to unlock this door. It's going to walk me extra into this area here. And good, we're shy. We're just shy of it. I think it could use maybe 1 pixel less, 2 pixels less maybe. I mean, when you put in all the art, textured quad, I think you're just talking about a regular display of a sprite using a 3D engine, like a 2D sprite and a 3D engine, right? You're just talking about regular quads. You're just talking about textures, basically. Yeah, right. Just like Salad Dong says here, yeah. I'm using a 2D engine called Cocos 2DX, and that 2D engine actually ends up doing 3D textures for everything. It's just that they're flat. You know, they're like, and they're at a certain height so that they peer perfectly and all that, always. So I guess yes. If you're asking yet about that in particular, yes, the Songbringer definitely uses textured quads. But indirectly, the game library handles that. Okay, now I'm gonna look over this code to make sure I didn't break anything. Yeah, good, I only affected these 4 lines. I just dialed in the walk to distances. So if you're walking through a locked door or into a locked room, actually, you're not going to walk onto any of these new gate tiles that are now in the world. Pinja, how do you go about starting a game? Well, you just kind of start, man. I guess a great way to learn how to start games is to watch Watch some Ludum Dare videos about how people made their Ludum Dare games. And that's kind of a good way if you don't know how to start a game. That's a good way to watch other people start a game, and then you can kind of get a feel for it. But also, you know, if you're into the general concepts of making games, I would check out Extra Credits' videos. They're great on how to do this and how to do that, and like just amazing videos, Extra Credits. Do modding. You finally understand? All right, man, you finally understand. Yeah, time lapses, exactly. Ludum Dare time lapses, other people's game dev time lapses. I gotta get caught up on my time lapses. I started doing that and then I stopped doing that and I gotta get caught up. I've been meaning to get caught up on all the time lapse videos. Check this in, man. This is a great fix. Boom, boom. Six bugs fixed in today's stream? Are you kidding? This is the most epic bug fixing stream ever. I've never gotten this many bugs fixed in one in less than 2 hours. This is amazing. Fixed a bug where the hero could walk onto thicket bushes if walking into a locked room. That really only applied to the thicket bushes because the other tile types remove themselves from the other room that you're walking into automatically. Like, for example, if you're walking through some bombable pillars, you bomb the one side, you walk into the next room, it's not going to have the bombable pillars again. And done. And close another one. 40's down to 47 cards. Whoa. Yeah, it is kind of hard to learn from them, but like the general concepts, like of like, you know, kind of watching people make art, for example, for a game, or the general concept of, okay, maybe they're using this software called Game Maker. And like, oh, here's kind of what code looks like in Game Maker. You know, that's what time lapses can be really useful for, or not even time lapses, but just like watching a video of someone actually making a Ludum Dare game. Yeah, you can't actually get any concrete information. It's just, but you do pick things up intuitively, I think. You pick things up with your subconscious mind a bit. Blood. Yeah, or like a make a simple game. Yeah. You know what? I think I could get one more bug fixed. Today's stream. This would be amazing. 7 bugs in one stream? Oh, no. I'm out of time. Oh, well. I'll get these bugs fixed. I'm hungry anyways. I'm going to get some lunch, dinner. But, yeah. So, I'm gearing up to do one more update. I did an update last night for Songbringer. It's up on Steam. And I will be doing another one tonight because there were some pretty critical bugs. Not critical, but just like this was kind of more of a buggy release than I've ever done. I really got to get these bugs fixed. So I'm going to do a patch release tonight and fix the gateway update. So there'll be another update to Songbringer on Songbringer's beta version tonight on Steam. And then I'll work the rest of this week on new features again and do the same thing next weekend. Yeah, I learned how to order the process of making game. Yeah, exactly, Rocket Bunny. Right. You're getting an overview of the whole process. Yeah, yeah. Thanks. There you go. Pinej, check out this link here at the end. Yeah, yeah, you already said cool. All right, cool. Nice. Yeah, Vlad, get something on the screen as fast as you can. Yeah. Okay, so that's it for today's stream. Thanks for watching, everybody, and it was cool to see all y'all. I'll be back tomorrow and streaming something else. I'll be working on some kind of new thing tomorrow. I'll probably be through most of my critical, important bugs to fix. I'll be working on some of my other things. I don't know, maybe Jib Controller 2. That'd be so sweet to finally have co-op. I don't know. So, yeah, it was good seeing y'all, and have a great one, everybody. Yeah.